I have thought about what would happen if Sally found out, and I'm scared that she'll die, so I don't want her to find out. The response to Sally, I think we were all anticipating and ready for a bit of a backlash. I was so grateful to Bill Hader and Alec Berg for not diluting a very complex female character. She's not a bad person, she's just a person. I think that one of the reasons why there's such a response to her and not a response to all of these men who kill people, besides your sort of average dose of misogyny, is that she's kind of that girl in your office, or she's someone we all know, or she's dialed up worst traits you know and you're recognizing yourself. And so I think the familiarity to a character like her sort of ups the allergy, whereas I don't know how many of us know, like, hitmen. I'm hoping you don't know a hitman. There's a bit of Sally in all of us, I'm afraid. I think that makes her dislikable.
Not really about you, it's more about me and my life, and so, and it's not really the kind of thing that, I think you'd be bored.
It's gonna be great.
It's risky territory going into a domestic abuse storyline in a half-hour comedy. So we were all incredibly vigilant about how we wanted to go about it. Bill and Alec are both really collaborative bosses, and they're both like, we're a couple of white guys, so what do the women think? Sadly, everybody seems to have a personal story of someone they know as well. We incorporated a lot of that to sort of walk that line of being sensitive about a topic, but also keeping it true to who she is, and that her story, like she says in her monologue, is not everyone's story. Liza Johnson she directed episode 4, which is the one where my ex-husband comes back. So it was great to have a woman running the show. There were lots of discussions, like there's a scene in the beginning of episode 4 where the husband first comes back, and the initial draft of that script, Sally was immediately so defiant, and she was really able to stand up to him and say all the things she wished she'd said. And we were all kind of like, this just doesn't feel real. Nobody has those words in the moment when they really need them or want them. And actually, it's clumsy, and you find yourself accidentally being polite. So we thought, what if she just tap dances through this? And what if it's this, like, there's two fires going, she's got her current boyfriend and her ex-husband, and that instead of actually being able to ground herself and stand up for herself, it becomes this kind of manic tap dance.
It's great, what you're doing is...
I'm terrified, okay? Because my piece is real. It's not a character, it's me. Raw, unapologetic truth with a capital T. All caps, actually, I'm thinking like a writer now.
The monologue in episode 7 for Sally was an idea that Bill had very early in shooting season 2, and he came up to me and said, I think we're gonna do this thing where we're gonna write like 2 pages and no punctuation, and you're just not gonna stop talking, it's gonna be one take, okay? And I was like, okay, cool. Sounds very theatrical, which was appealing to me. I had a good time kind of throwing in some little asides, and I feel like Sally is obsessed with watching famous actresses on YouTube. So I had this whole thing in my head that she's like obsessed with Annette Bening in American Beauty, and that scene where she's talking to herself at the table, one of the greatest scenes in cinema.
We'll just leave it all up to Carolyn. You mean you're gonna take care of everything now, Carolyn?
Yes, I don't mind, I really don't.
You mean everything? You don't mind having the sole responsibility? Your husband feels he can just quit his job?
Sally is so inundated with these YouTube videos that she doesn't even know that her life has become a kind of mimicry, and like what's reality and what's actually just her acting obsession.
I mean, this is just my story, but what if you get it wrong, Sally? I don't know, you can't get it wrong, Sally, but you can't not tell it either, Sally, because it's who you are.
We got to the day to shoot it, and we're all so comfortable with each other now. I'm never really nervous on set anymore, but I was really nervous because I knew it was going to be one take, well, multiple takes, but one, you know, one long take. And I rehearsed the whole piece like a song. Sally talks so quickly, and I talk quickly, but she talks a bit faster. So I slowed the whole thing down in rehearsing it and worked out every beat of it like a melody almost, and then worked on speeding it up and speeding it up and speeding it up. It was kind of like a little piece of music that I was hoping I could like hit the notes, you know? We did a take, and Alec was directing, and Bill was very sweet after and got the whole crew to applaud. And then Alec was like, great, we're moving on. And I was like, no. I was like, I've worked so hard on this and it's one take and I need to do it again. So I think in the end we did 4 takes. I never ask for extra takes, but this felt like a special occasion. And I think we used the 4th take because it was finally the one where I really just enjoyed it and sort of let go of the sheet music and was like, just having fun. I think that Sally, now that we've gone so deep into this story of her past, I think it would be really challenging thing to find out she's with a violent man again. That said, the violence is not directed toward her and Sally's power of delusion is boundless. So I wonder which direction she would go, and I'm not sure what the guys are thinking in that regard, but we'll see.